Hello everyone. Today we are going to study structure of a pollen grain and ovule. Let us study what is a pollen grain. Before this you have studied androecium. It is just a filament and it contains pollen grains. Pollen grain is just a fine yellowish powder like substance. It is unicellular and microscopic. If you observe the pollen grain under the microscope, you will find inside there is a nucleus, around the nucleus cytoplasm and a two-layered structure. If in this two-layered structure, at some places you will find there are some opening called as pores. This is the nucleus. Due to the presence of nucleus, it is a living cell. Cytoplasm. This is the outer layer called as exine, inner layer called as intine. Exine is generally rough. Sometimes it is spiny, or in case of the aquatic plants, it may be waxy. Exine is made up of a chemical known as sporopollenin. The intine, generally it is a smooth structure. The germ pore, it is just an opening through which the pollen tube can come out. Now let us study the structure of the ovule. You have studied the gynoecium. Inside the gynoecium, in the ovary, there are one or many ovules. Let us study this ovule in detail. These ovules are attached to the ovary with a structure called as placenta. In case of angiosperm, the ovule is always anatropous. Anatropous ovule, that is, it is inverted. You will find this is the structure of the anatropous ovule. This stalk is called as funicle. The attachment of the ovary to the ovule is called as hilum, and there is a dark structure called as raphe. This structure has outermost two-layered structure. These two layers are called as integuments. The opening at the lower end is called as micropyle. Opposite to the micropyle is the chalaza. Inside these integuments, there is a structure called as nucellus. Inside the nucellus, there is an embryo sac. Embryo sac is a 8 nucleated 7 celled structure. It contains 8 nucleus and 7 cells. Let us see the embryo sac in detail. 3 cells at the top, 3 cells at the bottom, and 2 cells in the middle. But these two nucleus in the single cell. The middle cell is called as egg cell. Near the egg cell, these two are synergids. Above structure is called as antipodals. The two nucleated cell is called as secondary nucleus. Let us study the function of each part in detail. First is the micropyle. Micropyle allows the entry of pollen tube. It allows the entry of the male gamete. Entry of pollen tube. The synergids, they help the pollen tube to enter. They help the egg to unite with the male gamete. The egg cell that grows into or it develops into zygote. The antipodals help in the process of fertilization. Help in fertilization. The funicle, it attaches the ovule to the placenta. Attach ovule to the placenta. Secondary nucleus develops into the endosperm. We have studied the structure of the pollen grain and ovule. Pollen grain, yellowish powder. It is a double layered structure. Outer exine, inner intine. Outer exine is rough, spiny or waxy. Intine is generally smooth. It is the male gamete. The female gamete is the ovule. In angiosperm, ovule is anatropous. We have seen this structure. This structure is inverted. It is anatropous. It contains the embryo sac, which is 8 nucleated 7 cell structure. We have seen the functions of the micropyle, synergids, egg, antipodals, funicle and the secondary nucleus. Micropyle is the opening that allows the entry of the male gamete, allows the entry of the pollen tube. The egg develops into the zygote. Secondary nucleus develops into the endosperm and the integuments, outer integument and the inner integument, they develop into seed coat. When the male gamete and the female gamete unite, zygote is formed. This process is called as fertilization. In the next video, we are going to study the process of double fertilization in angiosperm. Thank you.